We're too blessed to be stressed, am I right? Too bad I wasn't feeling like that the other day. You ever been so violent that after you were done being violent, you went straight to thinking about what classes you were gonna take in prison? I'm about to say, I know I'm not the only crazy one, you know what I mean? Thinking for the future. But you know, I'm just serious. But I'm gonna get to these jokes, because I've been looking at the crowd and y'all look like y'all want these jokes back to back. Like, ha-ha, next joke, brother. But, you know, I like performing in front of crowds like this. You know what I'm saying? Because, this young brother, I already seen all 32 of his teeth, and I ain't even say the first joke yet. And that builds confidence. Let me leave him alone before he meet me after the show. What's going on, funny man? Say something funny now, Mr. Funny Man. How about you talk about all 32 of my teeth again, huh? I dare you. But anyway, let's get into this complaining. I'm a person that gives off a lot of love, right? And when you give off a lot of love, there's people out there who will hate on you for nothing. Do you feel me? Yeah. Hold on. I'm gonna have to ask that again. When you give off a lot of love, there's people out there who will hate on you for nothing. Do you feel me? Yeah. Well, can the church say amen? Yeah. Well, let's start this sermon. So there's this chick, right? This girl that goes to my gym. And she hates me for nothing. And this girl got so many gaps and cracks in her teeth, it looked like she'd be chewing on bricks for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And I don't even know this shit. The most I ever gave her was a high and a five, especially with how bad her mouth smelled. Her breath so stinky, it smelled worse than the zookeeper's fingers. You know how bad your mouth got to smell worse than the zookeeper's fingers? That means your tongue and your teeth stink. But then my homeboy, he's the one that deals with her, right? You know what I mean? But then he I love the way y'all laugh. But then he tells me, after he was dealing with her, he tells me the back of her neck so stink, it smelled worse than the inside of an umpire's mask. I said, well, then what are you dealing with her for? You know what I'm saying? He's my homie. You know what I'm saying? You're supposed to take my side. But then he goes, you know how I like my women, Ben. I said, I guess so. Because then the next day he tell me that she's so dirty, when you went to give her a hickey, it tasted like he was sucking on some unwashed greens. I was like, you know what? You better stop telling people you know me. But at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? If this girl came to me and introduced herself and got to know me, I guarantee you she'll love me way more than she hate me. True story. But I know I'm not the only one that goes to the gym in here, because I saw somebody eating a carrot earlier. And they was dipping it in liquor. I love the way you laugh. I love it. But, this girl, right? She got some homegirls. I love it. She got some homegirls that goes to the gym. You know what I mean? Instead of hating on me, they came straight to me and introduced themselves. And now, every time I see them, it's nothing but laughing and joking. Like, a couple weeks ago, you know what I mean? I'm in the gym, and they called me over. Hey, Ben, come here. As soon as I went over there, I went straight in. I was like... Why does it smell like an NFL huddle over here? One of the girls like, shut up, Ben. Ben, when are you going to take me out to get something to eat? I said, take you out to get something to eat, huh? I was just about to ask you if you was hungry, but I see you brought the corns on your feet and the peas off your nappy chest hair. And the original girl was like, Ben, you're a good-looking brother. Why don't you give me some tips on how to get a brother like you, seeing how I got this hourglass shape and everything? I was like, hourglass, huh? Yeah, if you brought that hourglass from the 99-cent store. But, you want some tips from me? I got you. Number one, stop matching your clothes with your yellow teeth. If you do that, I guarantee you'll be way more successful in life. And letter two, yeah, I said letter two. Now I'm gonna stop for a second. I'm gonna say some jokes that you got to catch, because I only got 5 minutes. Now I see this side is flowing with me, but this side I may need to hand out some Tylenol. Does everybody understand English over here? No? Okay. But letter two, I'm talking to these females, right? I was like, why all you girls' jaws so strong? Y'all the only chicks I know come to the gym just to lift weights with your face. And number C, yeah, I said number C. I was like, what's with all these Israelite belts you girls keep wearing? What is that, fake Gucci? One girl's like, waist trainer. I said, here we go. Listen, people. If you're trying to get to a certain health in life, all you gotta do is eat right, you know what I mean, exercise right for the rest of your life, and I guarantee you get there. Everybody always looking for a shortcut. Waist training. You still got to train. But then I was like, you know what, ladies? Let's be serious, right? I want y'all to tell me which one of y'all got bugs in your house? Because I know one of y'all got bugs. One of the girls raised her hand. And I was like, oh Lord, here we go. All right, give it to me. She was like, no, it ain't nothing serious. I just got 4 rats and 3 roaches. I said, what kind of section 8 multiplication gave you them numbers? She, and one of the girls started laughing. I was like, damn it, what is so funny? What, did Vitamin Water come out with a strawberry shortcake flavor or something? But I got the light, and that seems like they're trying to tell me your $20 has expired. So my name is Ben Haslub, B-N-H-A-S-L-U-B, Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, follow me.